Okay, good evening, dear women. Brochot avot, I'm happy to see you. Today is a special lesson. I would like first to ask, Rezat Hashem, Shehegiya Mashiach, to kill him, Amen, Amen, Eliyahu, Eliyahu, Shehegiya, Mashiach, Mashiach, David, Eliyahu, Zichur Latov. As I'm speaking, that Mashiach will be here, Rezat Hashem. I would like to tell you, I had a lot of thinking, I made a lot of thinking before I prepared this lesson. And I'll tell you why. I decided, because people ask me, do we need to go to Israel? Why do you say that we need now to go to Israel? So, I would like to tell you, I brought you from the Ketubim, when it's written that Mashiach is going to be here. When the war of Gog and Magog will be. Listen, dear women, I gave you from the Ketubim, like, you know, ממש קצה הקרחון. The tip of the iceberg of from the Ketubim, when everything is going to happen and to start. And I'm bringing it through the Zohar HaKadosh and through Hagera, Gaon Mevilna, that translated it, Natan interpretation to it, with dates. Because we are walking now in those dates, and because it is knocking on our door, I would like to explain to you everything. You remember that a few times I told you that by the book of Chemdat Yamim that wrote Rabbi Shalom Shabbat, Zichutot Hagen Aleinu, I told you already that the times of Mashiach already started at the beginning of this hundred, the Jewish hundred, the Jewish count, okay, which means Tafshin. It's 5,700. This is the beginning of this, and then on Tafshin there was the Shoah, the Holocaust. So this was part of the Mashiach time. Everything, all this. It says in the Zohar HaKadosh, Mashiach times will be 100 years. It means from the beginning of... the 700 until the end of the 700. We are now at 5,700 here. 772. Which means we have only 28 years left. Listen what? Very carefully. Sorry?
Girls, please, go ahead.
28 years left. Listen, it says, the Rambam says, that 200 years before the last 7,000, 200 years, it will be the 200 years of pleasure. Klamar ta'anugot, God will give us everything. But these, what is left out, which means we are the generation of Mashiach women. Listen very carefully. What I'm giving you now, I know that a lot of people will have a question mark and it will be a problem, but I want to tell you, I had so many thoughts about it, if I will give it or not, but then I said, "Lo ta'amod al dam re'echa." If I'm giving lectures, I have to spread it out, they have to know the truth from the pardes, because we are now standing in the times of Mashiach, and everything is going to happen this year, it will start. The beginning of the Tafshin Ayin Bet. Tafshin Ayin Bet. This year, you see, listen, please don't talk in the middle. Just come over here so you can read.
5,072.
We are welcome. I'm happy to see you. You needed to hear the lecture. Come and sit down.
How we know that exactly?
עכשיו אני אלמד אתכם. אני אראה לכם. אני תביאו לי להגיד לכם. Dear women, listen very carefully. You'll ask me why I'm giving the lecture now. So I'll give you a parable. There was a rabbi that went with his son to a journey in Russia to another city. And the journey, you remember, at that time there were carriages and horses. And the journey was long. So when they went into the carriage, you know, children, the son said to his father, "Father, tell me, ask the person that you know rides the carriage, tell him how long do we have, how many days do we have?" So his father looked at him with a harsh face and he said, "Why are you asking?" He said, "It's only the beginning of the journey. You are not allowed to ask now." So the son felt embarrassed. He did not ask. After 3 days, the father, the rabbi, asked the person, you know, that drives the carriage, he asked him, "Tell me, how long do we have yet? We have a few hours or one day?" So the son looked at his father and said, "Father," you know, he had a question mark on his face. So the father looked at him and said, "Listen, at the beginning of the journey, there was a long time until we come reach the place that we had to go to. But now that we are so close to it, this is the time to ask questions." Dear women, at the beginning, at the beginning, when the ruining of the second temple happened, there was like 2,000 years until Mashiach will come. So then they said in the Gemara and everywhere that people who say when the end is will be cursed. But they said when the times of Mashiach comes, you have to spread the word. This is the time of Mashiach. Dear women, it started on Tammuz, the month of Tammuz, the Hebrew month of Tammuz, last year. Bezrat Hashem, this year, on the time of Tammuz and Av, Mashiach will be already here. It's the finish, it's the end. At the beginning of next year, all of the nations will be going to the land of Israel, to Jerusalem, exactly as it's written in the prophets. Listen very carefully. This is the time to go back to the land of Israel. This is the time. This is the time, dear women, that we should go back home. This is the time that you should be prepared. This is the time that we need to remember who we are and what we are in this world towards Hashem.
Can you repeat again like this, like very quickly?
Okay, this is the time that we need to remember. I told you, the time. This is the time schedule. It started on Tammuz, last year, the Hebrew year I'm talking, Tammuz. Okay, 5,771 Tammuz, on the month of Tammuz. Now listen very carefully. This year, Tammuz Av, it says on Av Ledat Mashiach, which means Mashiach will appear. It says at the beginning of 5,773, I will show you from the Zohar, it says that the nations will go to Jerusalem to fight over the land of Jerusalem because the children of Israel will not give up Jerusalem. Even though we are pressured from all over, we will not give up Jerusalem, and they will all come to the land of Jerusalem, the land of Israel, to Jerusalem.
The other nations?
All nations, all the going, can, they will come, and all of them will be on. I already told you
once. They're going to fight us, or they're going
to... Yes, they will fight over Jerusalem, and
all the Islamists are taking over the Arab Spring. They're all Islamic fanatics.
Dear women, do you understand? That's what's going to happen by the prophets, and by the Zohar. I will explain. I will give you. I thought about giving this lesson a lot, but I decided, I told my sister before, I won't have the courage to give it. I should give it because if God wanted me to do it, I should do it. I have to tell you, this is the interpretation of the Gera, the Gaon Mevilna, who said that the year Tafshin Ayin Bet, this year, this Jewish Hebrew year, Tafshin Ayin Bet, 5,772. Is the beginning, Mashiach is here, is the beginning of the end of Be'itah. Because I told you there are two times that the Mashiach can come. One of them, it's the time that was already written and decided by Bereshit. Bereshit bara Elokim et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz, ve-aretz et ha-tohu ve-bohu ve-choshech al pnei tohom ve-ruach Elokim merachefet al pnei ha-mayim, which means the spirit of God was all over the water, was floating over the water. This was the spirit of Mashiach, which means that already in the beginning, at the first pasuk, first verse in the beginning in Bereshit, already there was time that Mashiach will appear. Nobody wanted to tell us the truth because we are now, from the ruining of the Second Temple, 1,943 years from then. So if somebody would have told them that it will take approximately 2,000 years, nobody would want to wait. 2,000 years is a long time. How many generations you have in 2,000 years? But now it is the time. So this is the time that I should tell you this. That's right. And I... Okay, so I would like to tell you everything that is written in the Gemara, the Sanhedrin, Daf Tzadik Zayin, which means that 97, the page 97, and also 98, already happened. We can see that all of the Nadlan, all of the Nadlan Banglit, Nadlan, Shachati Akshah. The property, the land.
Real estate.
All of the real estate all over the world goes down. The real estate in Israel is up and high, and the value of the real estate in Israel is like fire. It's so you cannot even buy it because the price is so high. You can see that the money all over the world goes down, the worth of the money, and you will see that the shekel goes up. You will see all over the world. It says that there will be plenty of food for everyone, but it will cost a lot and it will be hard to buy even food. Dear women, everything that is written happens. Everything already.
Just
71
is already started.
Tammuz should be the Mashiach,
everything will
start.
Tammuz. 72 is already started.
Yes.
And when is it going to
Tammuz Av.
In
Tammuz Av. It's the month of Tammuz
July.
And Av.
July.
Soon July.
It's like three the summer.
Yes, it's kind of July, August. Okay. Everybody has to be ready. Bezrat Hashem. Listen very carefully. Shh. Dear women, and now I would like to speak to you and to show you.
What about 28 years?
Which one you said
before? Wait, the 28 years, there's going to be 27 years of war.
Oh my God.
Between the nations. The nations, dear women, listen. Shh. That's what's written. I want to give you what is written. Okay? Let's continue. Shh. It's written by Midrash Rabbah. I'll explain everything. Let's do it together and write on a piece of paper all the questions that you have. I will answer at the end. But let me first give you all the information, everything that I can. It will be only the tip of the iceberg. But you have to know, because it's my responsibility also to give it out. It's not good that I will have this knowledge and won't pass it out to you. So it's very important. Dear women, Midrash Rabbah, Dvarim Rabbah. It says over there, בדברים רבה, פרק א' יוד א', it says over there, אמר רבי אילאי בשם רבי יוסי בן זמרה, כך אמר הקדוש ברוך הוא, which means רבי אילאי said in the name of רבי יוסי בן זמרה, this is what Hashem told us. He told אברהם אבינו, לאברהם, שיגאל את בניו בשתי אותיות. He says, I'm going to save your children with two letters. Listen again, the letters, the Hebrew א' ב'. He says, מיניין שכך כתיב, וגם את הגוי אשר יעבדו דן אנוכי, which means, he goes back to the ברית בין הבתרים, which you remember that God told Abraham Avinu that his children are going to be for 400 years slaves to a nation that they know, do not know her, dear women. So he says, I'm going to come and redempt them, he says, בשבעים ושתיים אותיות, in 72 letters. What is 72? He says, I'm going to redeem the children of Israel, give deliverance to the children of Israel in 72 letters, it says. Now you know that the exile of Egypt included all of the exiles in it, which means Babel, Iraq, Babel, it included the Babel, Madai, Yavan, and Edom. This is the Galut Edom. So it included all of the Galuyot inside them, dear women. So it says, אמר רבי יהודן, מלבוא לקחת לו גוי, עד סוף הפסוק, 72 אותיות. Even the pasuk, even the verse, has 72 letters to hint us that God is going to save. The name of the deliverance of Hashem is the name of 72 letters. Listen very carefully. רבי אבי אמר בשמו געלם, ושמו 72 אותיות. He says, in his name he delivered them, and his name is 72 letters. What does it mean? It means, listen very carefully, what is 72? 70, look, what is 72? 5,772. You see it over here? זאת אומרת, עין בית שמות. עין בית שמות. That's Tashad. You see it over here? Taf, Shin, Ayin, Bet. Why is Ayin is 70 numerical value? Bet is 2. Together it's 72. 72 names of Hashem. This is Tehesh, not Ayin, Bet, which means this year, 72 names of Hashem is all above us. This name, 72, Ayin, Bet, is the name of God, Yud, Kei, Vav, Kei, which you put all the letters for Yud, Yud, Vav, Dalit, you put it inside the letters, and you put Bemilu Yudin, which you put the Yud in the Milu. I cannot explain more than that, but I'm giving you in general. You put the Yudin inside. This is the name of deliverance of Hashem, and it's all over us now. Ze Shema Geula. This is the name of deliverance, which means Ayin Bet, 72, equals Chesed. Chesed, Chet in numerical value is 8, Samech is 60, Dalet is 4. How much is it? 60 plus 8 plus 4, 72. Dear women, Olam Chesed Ibane, the world is going to be built with mercy. It's going to be built. The future world, the world of Mashiach is going. Pay attention. It's written in chapter 89 in Tehillim. King David writes it over there. Olam Chesed Ibane. He doesn't write that the world was already built with mercy, but the world is going to be built with mercy. So Olam Chesed Ibane. This is the name of deliverance of Hashem, the Ayin Bet. This is this year, Taf Shin Ayin Bet. It says קץ הגאולה האחרון by the Zohar הקדוש, the deliverance, the last deliverance, בעיתה, because we already passed Vachishen. I told you there were two times. One is on the from the beginning God decided a date which is going to deliver all the children of Israel and the whole world. And the second one is Vachishena, that we could have made it before, if we made tshuva, if we loved each other, if we remembered Hashem when he needed to remember him, it could have happened differently. But because we did not succeed in doing that, then this is the time, this is the time of Beita. This is the time that was already decided from the beginning. This is the date which was decided. So it says Bazor HaKadosh, in Parashat Vayet Hanan, it says over there in Parashat Vayet Hanan Ayin Dalet, and then also Vayikra Tet Zayin, it says, Oy lanu ki pana yom ki natu tzlelei erev, which means, Oy lanu, you know what Oy is. It says Oy, like Oy vavoy. Oy lanu, that now the day is going, and we can see, you know, the time that before the evening, in between the times before, when the day is almost ended, the life of the sun is almost ending, and then we have the beginning of the night. So it says, "Oy lanu ki pana yom ki natutz lalei erev." Yom betzelu sof galuta. It's the end of the exile. Veshua dehaitzel sit kamtzinu falga, which means shesh vachetzi shaot, which means the end is 6.5 hours. It means the time of Mincha, the time of Mincha Gdola. There are three times of Mincha. You know, the Halakha says there are three times of Mincha. There's big Mincha, Mincha Gdola, there's small Mincha, Mincha Ktana, and there's Peleg Mincha. Peleg Mincha, which means a small part of Mincha, this is the time. The big Mincha is at the beginning, when you can say around 1:30. It's the beginning when you say Mincha. It's 6.5 hours. From the day, then you can say Mincha. And then 9.5 hours, it's called Mincha Ktana, the small Mincha. And then Palga Mincha is like 1 hour before Arvit, before you say Arvit, it's almost Dimdumim. Yes, in between. So this is Mincha Gdola. So the Gera, the Gaon Mevilna says, the Perush of this 6.5 hours, it's we went into the 6,000th year, he said. This one is the beginning of the 6,000th year, and it's 6.5 hours from the 6,000th year. The Gera calculated, and it's the year of Taf Shin Ayin Bet, which means it's 5,772. It's this year. This is the year of Mashiach. This is the end. This is the year. Now listen, even the Maya, you know, other tribes, not Jewish tribes, by astronomy, they finished the calendar on the year of 2012, the end of 2012. Listen how it's... I would like to tell you something. How do we know that this is really... They were correct about... How do we know they were correct? Because I'm telling you, in the Zohar it's written that this is the time that Mashiach will show himself, and that all of the nations will go to Jerusalem at the beginning of the Hebrew year, 5,773... It's the beginning of next Hebrew year, you understand? And this is in between 2012. It's at almost the end of 2012, because when we have our new year, it's September. It's September, and it's not the new year. It's the last year of the nation's calendar, do you understand? Yes. When we start our year, their year is not finished yet, because their year is by the sun and our year is by the moon. So when we have our Rosh Hashanah, it's almost at the end of the year. Usually it's September, the end of September, October. Yes. And then 2 months after, David. So when we finish the Hebrew year, 5,772, and begin the next year, it's their end of the year, you understand? So everything is in correlation, even their calculations. And they did their calculations by astronomy. So dear women, it's not the end, because it's the beginning of a new era. It's a good era. We have a zchut to be the generation of Mashiach. We have the zchut. It's a big zchut, dear women.
Is it a property in Jerusalem or in Israel itself?
Sorry? In Israel and Jerusalem and all the world.
No, I'll ask you why.
In Israel. In Israel, all Israel.
What's going to happen in the summer?
Write your questions. Let me first give everything that I wrote on the board. I'll explain so you have. Please write it down and pass it to other people. It's important. So, dear women, I'm showing you over here that Mashiach's time is now this Hebrew year. So it says, Dayal etzara bishata. Moshe Rabbeinu says to Hashem, enough for a trouble when the times come. Dayal etzara bishata. And I told you already that the 72 names of Hashem is the name of deliverance, Ein Bet. And this is really the name of this year. Tehesh Nat Ein Bet. This is the name of deliverance. Ma? Tehesh Nat Gula. Tehesh Nat Ein Bet. Zatavshin Ein Bet. Tehesh Nat Ein Bet. Ein Bet ze chesed begimatria. Olam chesed ibane. Ibane leatid lavo. Lama ishtemesh David HaMelech ibane bilshon atid velo bilshon avar kvar nivna olam. כי זה הזמנים של משיח. חסד זה 72 בגימת, זה עין בית. So this is the name of deliverance. So I would like to tell you, it says that when Moshe Rabbeinu, because it's parallel to what happened in Egypt, Harizal says that our generation is the souls of the generations that were in Egypt and went out of Egypt, dear women. So that's why it says, בזכות נשים צדקניות נגלו עם ישראל ממצרים, בזכותן עתידים נגלו. Because of righteous women, we were saved and we had deliverance from Egypt, and because of us righteous women, dear women, we are going to be delivered again. God is going to deliver us from this exile. Listen very careful, the power is in the hands of the women. You understand? Because it's parallel to what would happen in Egypt. So dear women, when Moshe Rabbeinu was the messenger, and you know, Maze Adam, I know I'm writing, I don't want to wipe the board because I need everything that I wrote here. Just wait. Okay.
But look. It's possible you can make some mistakes here in compilation.
This is the Gerah did it. I didn't do it. This is the Gerah. I'm giving you what's written in the books. From the Zohar HaKadosh and the Gerah and all the interpretation, you'll see. It's not only him. It says that Arav Kaduri, Zchutot Hagan Aleinu, Arav Kaduri said that Mashiach will appear on Tisha B'Av this year, Bezrat Hashem. It says that Arav David Abu Chatzera Ben Ari Shalita, he says also that Mashiach will appear this Tammuz, this Av, Chodesh Av, dear women. So look. Look please over here. I wanted to show you what is Adam first. Adam is the first human being, Adam HaRishon, okay? And Dalet is David HaMelech, and Mem is Mashiach, and Moshe. Because Mashiach will have also the spirit of Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu was the first deliverer, and he will be also the last one. But I would like to tell you, so when Moshe Rabbeinu saw the snake, he saw the fire on the tree, on the snake, and he saw that nothing happened to him.
What is
men? Mashiach ve Moshe. Dear women, this is a cycle. Adam HaRishon, this is a cycle of fixing in this world. Adam HaRishon gave 70 years of his life to David HaMelech, because David HaMelech was supposed to die because of the sin of Adam HaRishon. He was supposed to live only 3 hours and to die. But then he gave him a present, and he told God he's going to write. He asked him, what is there in heaven? So he said, there's shtar, there's a treaty of present you can give from your years to David, King David. So he gave him 70 years. And then King David taught us to do tshuva, to repent over our sins. So he taught us to do tshuva. And then Moshe Rabbeinu, Mashiach when comes, Mashiach Ushiye, Mashiach when he comes, there won't be any death anymore. Beshachat layetzer hara, which means the beginning was with Adam HaRishon, that he sinned, that death came to the world, and Mashiach will take off the death, because this is the time, this is a new beginning, it's a new era, an era of chesed.
Wait, so, in July it's going to be like no death anymore?
No, it will be the beginning of all this, until it's finished, until, because Mashiach is going to rule the whole world, dear women. Mashiach is going to be the king of the whole world. Mashiach is the representative of Hashem in this world. And God says, you're learning my Torah, but you're not waiting for my kingdom. What is the kingdom of HaKadosh Baruch Hu? The kingdom is Mashiach. Because Mashiach is going to rule the whole world. He won't have earthly powers, he will have godly powers. God will give him such powers that everybody...
Oh, Yaros HaKol, but what about all the people?
הרבה לא ישארו פה, התשיעסנו, אבל עוד מעט, תביאו לי, תביאו דבר דבר, אני אביא לכם, אז תביאו נעשה את זה בשלבים שאני אוכל להסביר את הכל. I will explain everything, בלי נדר, בעזרת השם, God will help you to explain everything that I started. Let me do it in an order so you can understand. So it says that Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, you are sending me to help the children of Israel, but what shall I tell him? What's your name, God? So it says over here, Eyeh Asher Eyeh, God says, tell him, this is my name, I will be whoever I am. Eyeh Asher Eyeh, אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא למשה. He says, לך, אמור להם לישראל, אני הייתי מכם בשעבוד זה, ואני אמכם בשעבוד מלכויות. He says, tell, go to the children of Israel and tell them, I was with you in this exile, the exile of Egypt, and I'm going to be with you in the later exile, which means the exile that is going to be in the future. And look what Moshe Rabbeinu tells him. And it says, אמר לפניו, ריבונו שלם, Moshe Rabbeinu tells him, God, he says, דיה לצרה בשעתה, please don't tell them that now. He says, let everything, you know, any trouble when it comes, then we will deal with it. דיה לצרה בשעתה. What does it mean? מה זה דיה לצרה בשעתה? Look, dear women, look how beautiful the Torah is. All the hints are here. This is the time that we should reveal the hints. בשעתה, here, I wrote it over here. דיה לצרה בשעתה. See over here, בשעתה. Look at the letters. Bet, Shin, Ayin, Taf, Hey. So בשעתה tells, says already, it gives a hint, what year will Mashiach come? And we are going to be delivered. Dear women, look. Hey is Hey, Alafim, which means 5,000. This 5, is the Hey. 5,000. And then Taf, Shin, Ayin, Bet. This is the year. You see it? This is the year. Let me, I'll show you everything and I will show you from the Nevi'im also, from the prophets. This is the year of Mashiach, dear women. When we write the Hebrew year, maybe some of you do not know how we write it. Look how we write it. When we write the Hebrew year, we write it like this, Hey, and then we write the year, Tash'av. Why? Because this Hey, numerical value is 5, we mean 5,000. Taf Shin, Taf is 400, Shin is 300 in numerical value, Ayin is 70, Bet is 2, together it's 772, okay? All of this. Oh. Hey is for stands for 5,000, okay? So this Moshe Rabbeinu already says when we are going to be delivered. Pay attention, we already have the year of deliverance, but I will show you in everything. When we say, El Nora Lila, El Nora Lila, Hamtzi lanu mechila, Bishat Haneila. Why did they write, El Nora Lila, you mighty God? Oh, we say to him, please, but forgive us at the time of Neila, the time that we are closed, the time of finishing. But we use the word in Hebrew, bishat. We do not use the word bizman. In Hebrew, you could use the word bizman at the time. We use bishat at the hour. At the hour. Listen very carefully. Instead of using the phrase bizman, bizman anila, we use it bishat at the hour. Why? Because they hinted to us, shh, bishat is the year of Tafshin Ayin Bet, this year. Dear women, it's hinted inside. It has to be on Yom Kippur hinted. It has to be, because this is the big deliverance day of Yom Kippur. We are cleansing ourselves on Yom Kippur. We are like angels. And when Mashiach comes, we will be all like angels, because we won't have Yetzirah, we won't have the evil inclination. Do you see? Do you see what I'm showing you here? But this is only the beginning, dear women. It's only the beginning. So, dear women, let's look. It says also, I told you, Ki meitzetcha me'eretz Mitzrayim arenu niflot. Exactly like I took you from the land of Egypt, I will show you miracles when Mashiach will come. That's what God says, because it's parallel to the exile in Egypt. We are now in exile of Edom. We are parallel to the exile, mamash, parallel to the exile of Egypt. So when was the redemption from the exile of Egypt? Because I'm thinking quickly, so I have the words in English. So it started on Tammuz, on the month of Tammuz, 2002, Bet is for, numerical value is 2, 2000 Tamaz. This was the year, on the month of Tammuz. And Makkah, the plague of blood started on the month of Av. So if we are parallel, it has to start again on the month of Tammuz and the month of Av. Do you understand?
But they everything. Came out in Pesach.
Can, but the beginning of everything, the beginning that will start, that Mashiach will show himself, there will be wars. And then Mashiach will make peace over all of the land, the whole earth will be in peace. That's his job. Mashiach ben Yosef was already here. We are waiting for Mashiach ben David. You understand? This is the time of Mashiach ben David.
Wait, who is Mashiach ben Yosef?
Mashiach ben Yosef, I cannot say who was Mashiach ben Yosef, but I can tell you that it can be not, it can be one person and it could be more than one person. Because there were sparks of his soul in different people, big rabbis, big tzaddikim, that they helped to prepare the world. To prepare the world for the coming of Mashiach ben David. Amen. We are standing in these times. We are the generation of Mashiach.
Right?
Look,
it says,
but in
the time the last year, so maybe they're all...
Listen, maybe.
Tammuz
bet alafim tamah. זה היציאת, זה ההתחלה של המקוד המצרים.
כמו שכתוב ש same souls who separated from Moshe in Midbar, same souls gonna meet Mashiach בעזרת השם.
בעזרת השם. אני אומרת לכם, we are parallel, אנחנו במקביל ליציאת מצרים. אנחנו הדור של יציאת מצרים. אנחנו ממש, חייבים לסגור מעגל, זה נקרא סגירת מעגל. הכל במעגל, זה נקרא סגירת מעגל. We are closing a cycle. This is a tikkun, this is a fixing, this is how it's supposed to be. So dear women, let's continue. Let me give everything and then write down your questions so I will answer them. But first you will see that I will give you the answers through everything that I wrote, Bli Neder, Bezrat Hashem, in Yetziata Dishmaya. So listen, it's written in Bereshit, at the end of the creation, it's written, Ve'achulo ha'shamayim, ve'aretz, ve'chol tzeva'im, ve'echal elokim b'yom ha'shvi, mikol melechto asher asa. Ve'ayvarech elokim b'yom ha'shvi, ve'kadesh oto. Now, you remember at the end, at the seventh day, it says that all of the sky and the earth and all of Tzba'am and all of the army of the sky, listen very carefully, and all of the army of the sky, everybody is resting on the seventh day. This is parallel to the times of Mashiach. Why is it parallel to the times of Mashiach? Because the seventh, we are already going inside. We don't have a lot of years to go into the 7,000. We are already, you know, almost inside that. And it says that on that time, Be'ezrat Hashem, everything, there will be peace, there will be rest, there will be, everything will be good. And how do we know that? How do we know it hints for Mashiach? Because Vayachulu, look over here. Vayachulu, Vav is numerical value 6, Yud is 10, Chaf is 20, Lamed is 30, and Vav is 6. How much is it? 20 plus 10 is 30, 30 plus 30 is 60, plus 6 is 66, plus another 6, 72. Second, 72. This is the word of Chesed. And it says all of the army of Hashem, dear women, the army of Hashem is already here. It means the angels. You know, sometimes people call them aliens. It's not aliens, dear women. This is the army of Hashem. What you see in the world is all, the army of Hashem is here. Already the third temple is going down from the seventh Rakia, from the seventh one. It's going down towards earth because this is the time. And we are supposed, you will ask me, but it says that there's a mitzvah to build the temple, the third temple. Dear women, we are going to build the Sha'arim, the gates that King David built, the gates of the temple. They are drowning in water now. And you know who keeps the gates? Korach. Korach keeps the gates, and we are going to take the gates and put the gates over there. And it says in the Jewish law that if a person puts the door on his home, even if he didn't build the whole home, it's considered that he built the home. So this is what we are going to do. It says that the third temple is going already down. We are going towards earth. Gan Eden, paradise will be here, Bezrat Hashem, when Mashiach is here. Listen very carefully.
So, I'm sorry, so the going people could see the aliens and they don't know it's Malachim? It's Malachim?
We don't know it's Malachim.
I'm telling you that this again, the army of Hashem is already here. What you see also with nature, this is the army of Hashem. Everything that happens, tsunami, hurricanes, everything, earthquakes, everything, this is the army of Hashem. Nothing can happen unless Hashem sends angels and causes it to happen. Do you understand? Nothing can happen without the word of Hashem. It has to come from the word of Hashem. So we are looking at Bayachulu, we see. This is Chesed too. Ayin Bet Shemot. This is Chesed. This is the name of deliverance. And then we have over here, Ayin Be'ayin Yuru Beshuv Hashem Tzion. It's written in the prophet Yeshayahu, chapter Nun Bet 52. And it's written over there, Ayin Be'ayin Yuru Beshuv Hashem Tzion, which means eye by eye they will see God. They will see the Shekhinah exactly like the children of Israel saw it when they went to cross the sea. They saw the Shekhinah, which means we'll see it with our eyes. We'll see the Shekhinah. It's parallel to what happened there. So you will ask me, so at what year we're going to see the Shekhinah? Dear women, Ayin Be'ayin, the Rashi Tevot, this Ayin Be'ayin is Ayin Bet 72. At the year of Tafshin, Ayin Bet, dear women, 72, it goes back to 72. And then it says, Ve'im Abdil Ben Maim Lemaim. It says, God is going to separate water from water, dear women. So look, Maim Ben Maim, the separation Ben Maim Lemaim. Look at this, Rashi Tevot, the first letters of each word. Bet, the numerical value is 2, Mem is 40, and Lamed is 30. Together it's 72, Ayin Bet. Bishnat Ayin Bet, God is going to make a difference, which means it's going to take the waters of exile and to separate it, the harsh waters, the waters of suffering of exile, from the waters of redemptance. Dear women, the waters of deliverance, the waters of mercy, those are hints inside the Ketuvim. And then we know at Sof Parashat Beshalach, I'm just giving you a tip of an iceberg, just to know, because you have to know. It's part of my... Sof Parashat Beshalach, it's written over there, Sof Parashat Beshalach, about Amalek. You remember that Amalek went to war with the children of Israel when they went out of Egypt. So it says over there, Ki yad al kesya milchama l'Hashem b'Amalek midor dor. Look at the words, milchama l'Hashem b'Amalek, which means there's going to be a war between Hashem and Amalek. Look at the first letters of this sentence, that God will make war against Amalek. Mem is 40, Lamed is 30, and Bet is 2, again 72. At the year Ayin Bet, this is the year Ayin Bet, 72. This, I'm giving you hints inside the Ketuvim. Tafshin Ayin Bet. Ki yad al kesya milchama l'Hashem b'Amalek midor dor. Dear women, listen very carefully. I did not finish, but let's continue. I told you already that from the Devarim Rabba it's written, Kshebah le'gaalam, gaalam b'shivim b'shtayim otiyot. When God is going to deliver us, it will be on the year that all His 72 names will be above us. This is the year that we have Tafshin Ayin Bet, Tehesh Nat Ayin Bet, 72, the name that is 72, that is considered 72. And then look, Ba'aleinu Lashabeach. You remember Ba'aleinu Lashabeach? We say that in the davening, in the prayer. Look, there's hints over there also. It says over there, Tishaba Kol Lashon, it says over there. You come to a chelek that says that every tongue will swear. It's written over there, Tishaba Kol Lashon, Lefanecha Hashem Elokeinu Ichru Bepoli. Everybody is going to bow down to you, is going to fall from their legs. Lichvod Shimcha Ikar Itenu. For the sake of your name, they will give everything, sacrifices and everything. This is about Mashiach. And what is, and when does Mashiach come? Look very carefully, dear women. Tishaba is the year Tav Shin Ayin Bet. At the year, this year, Tishaba, it's the letters, here. Tishaba, Tafshin Ayin Bet, Betishaba Av Nolad Mashiach. Tafshin Ayin Bet, look, dear women, Tishaba, this is the year of Tafshin Ayin Bet. And as I told you, when we say the song of El Nora Alilam Tzilanu Mechila, Bishat Anila, this is also, this is a hint that this is the year of deliverance, Bezrat Hashem. Ken, this is the year of redemption, this is the year of deliverance. Bezrat Hashem. Now, dear women, what will happen? Ken, יחרו ויפולו ולכבוד שמך עיקר יתננו. זה במזמור שלנו לשבח. כל מי שישאר, בטח, גם הגויים. כולם יכירו בשם של הקדוש ברוך הוא, בעזרת השם. Dear women, so why did I tell you this? Why did I tell you this? I have to give you, let me just continue with my thoughts, so I will open all the books, because then I have to remember what chapters I wanted to open. So wait, I'll open Yechezkel, Yechezkel, the prophet Yechezkel, chapter 33, Lamed Gimel. You can write it down so I can tell you.
עין בעין יראו ושוב
השם ציון.
זה איפה אמרת ישעיהו כמה?
נון ב' ישעיהו 52.
זה היה פסוק או פרק?
זה הפרק. הפסוק, אני לא, אני חושבת שזה אולי ה', אבל אני לא בטוחה, אני צריכה לבדוק, או ח'.
אין בעיה,
אבל לא משנה, תפתחי, תראי את זה. זה Dear women, it's written, God says in chapter 33 in the prophet Yechezkel, he says over there about the spiritual leaders of the children of Israel. He says, and I looked at the chapter and and that's why I decided eventually to give you what the knowledge. It's only a small part that God gave me to know, in order that I will pass it through. This is the time that the Gera, the Gaon Mevilna, already calculated. And you'll see a lot of the big tzaddikim also came to this year. This is the year of deliverance. And it says over here that Ve'ata ben adam tzofen et aticha lebet Yisrael. And it says God says, I put you as a person who will teach, who will lead the children of Israel. It speaks to the spiritual rabbis, rabbitsons, all the women, all the people that give Shurei Torah, that give the Torah lessons. ואתה בן אדם צופן את עתיך לבית ישראל. ושמעת מפי דבר והזהרת אותה ממני. And he says, and you will listen from my mouth, you will have the knowledge, and you have to להזהיר, not warn, and you have to warn the children of Israel, warn them of what is going to happen, warn them that they will have to go in my ways. And we're going to study Tomer Dvorah in order that you will have the merit in order to go in the ways of God. Because he who does not have good characteristics, it does not have Torah. It doesn't matter how much Torah he studied. Yeah. Listen, it's parallel to a chavit, to a container that has a great yain meshubach, great wine inside, but it has a small hole at the bottom. If somebody has a lot of Torah, and you know what happens to the wine, this great wine? Everything goes out of the container. Like Doeg HaEdomi, which went against David HaMelech, against King David, and Achitophel went also against King David. Both of them were in the Sanhedrin. It was the top court of the children of Israel. They were big rabbis. Their knowledge was bigger. You know, King David was afraid of Achitophel. Achitophel knew the secret names of Hashem. He was afraid. Achitophel was one of the Sanhedrin in the times of David HaMelech. Wow. And he was the one that also was the advisor of King Shaul. King Shaul, and he told him how to go against David HaMelech. But I would like to tell you, both of them, all of the Torah that they knew did not help them come to Gan Eden. They were punished for it. Because all of the Torah went out of the barrel through this small hole, the hole was the characteristics. A person who does not have good characteristics does not have Torah, dear women. That midot. מי שאין לו מידות טובות, אין בו תורה. בפירוש, כל התורה, dear women, because I already told you that the Torah can be either a drug of life or a drug of death.
This should be on every money bill.
כן, ככה, the Torah can be either the drug of life or the drug of death. I think two lessons ago I gave you this, and I explained it to you. But dear women, we're going to study Tomer Dvorah so we can change our characteristics. Dear women, to the grave, everybody goes and comes and will escort us to the grave. But from there on, we are all alone. That's it. We do not have no one to escort. Not our children, our husbands, our mothers, our fathers, or all our friends, everyone else, and not even our property. Nothing goes with us. From there on, we are all alone. At the true world, there's no mercy. There's justice. There's only judgment. Judgment which is just. There's emet, only truth. Do you understand? So you have to understand, that's why everybody should have the fear of God inside and should say, well, but I will stand in front of Hashem. What shall I tell him? He knows every secret thought that I have. And if I did something bad, even if I tried to speak to a person and I had, you know, bad thoughts about it and I spoke and I had, and I wasn't clean, God knows that. He will show me it. And you cannot say over there, oh, I didn't mean this, I meant that. It does not help. God knows the true meaning. So God says to the leader of the children of Israel, I'm warning you, you have to tell them everything that I tell you, God says. You have to deliver everything to them. Because if you won't, he says, when I say to the wicked person, you are a wicked person, motamut, you're going, because of your sins, you're going to die, he says, and you did not warn him because you wanted, you know, sometimes it's very hard to warn people and to explain to them because people do not want to listen. But sometimes if you are in that, in a position that you can do a difference, and if you're in a position that you give lectures, Torah lectures, you should help people change their character. This is the building block. Change their characteristics. If you did not do that, and if you did not say, you know, you did not do something right, you should change it. This is what you need to do, because this is what Hashem wants you to do. So God says, listen very carefully. Ve'lo dibart la'azir Hashem midarko, hu asha ba'avono yamut. This wicked person will die because of his sins. And his blood I'm going to ask from you. Which means his sins, God forbid, is going to be upon your head.
What consider sins? What he could do? Dugma, the teachers.
Better. Okay. Well, I'm going to explain why I'm saying that. This is very important. Why? Because, for example, if a person, for example, God forbid, Asad Gezel, you know, he stole from a non-Jewish person. And the rabbi of this community did not say anything and blessed him and he behaved to him as usual. And all of the other community thinks that this is the right thing to do. Because if the rabbi says it's okay, then it's the right thing to do. Then what will happen, this wicked person is going to be punished. But the blood, which means the nefesh, the blood of this person will be upon the head of this rabbi of the community. Do you understand? The rabbi, Rabbitson, or anyone that gives lectures, because if God gave him the opportunity to teach his mamash. This is in Yechezkel, it's very serious. So if God gave you the opportunity to teach, I gave you the opportunity to teach my children. It's a big responsibility.
Sorry, but if the rabbi or Rabbitson, yes, teaching, but those people still don't understand.
That's a different thing. That's a different thing. A different thing, but if it came, that's a different thing because it did deliver the message. But if it fell on Oznaim Arelot, this is a different thing. But it's their our responsibility. All the people that lecture Torah lessons, it's their responsibility to explain to everyone that is in the room. Not that those people will like them. They need to understand what God wants from them in a nice way. But they need to understand correctly what God wants from them. If it's niyut, which means modesty, if it's tmimut, which means to be honest with God and His children, which is very important, and respect to have between God, between ourselves, a Jewish person to another one, and all the children of Hashem, which includes all of the nations, everything that we need, this is from Hashem. Those are the laws of Hashem. But God
said. The big rabbi said in Yerushalayim, I heard in one funeral, in very large rabbi said passed away. Very known rabbi said, and on her funeral, because the rabbi came to give Nichum Avelim, and he says like that, when the Talmidei Chachamim, rabbis and rabbi says, give the shiurim, and it's not works, they did give, and it still goes, bad things going on in their community, that rabbi or that tzaddik rabbi said, they are going kaparat abonot,
over
his or their generation. That's why they are dying young.
Yes,
that's what
it's true. It's true. Dear women, listen very carefully. So this is what's written in Lamed Gimel. But we are going to continue because you wanted to know what's going to happen. So it says like this, that all of the nations, it says, will come, the trouble will start in the north. It says in Perek Lamed Chet, Mitzafon Tipatach Hatzara, on Lamed Chet of Yechezkel, it starts, Ben Adam Simpanecha El Gog Eretz Amagog, which mean Gog u'Magog, the war of... It says, they asked the Chafetz Chaim, they asked him, the Chafetz Chaim, tell us, when the first world war started, they asked the his Hasidim asked him, is this the war of Gog and Magog? So the Chafetz Chaim answered them, no, there are going to be three wars of Gog and Magog. It will be separate. The first war is this one. Then there will be a stop. Then there will be a second war, which was the Holocaust, the Second World War. Then there will be again a stop. And then there will be a third war, which is Gog and Magog. You understand? It will be separated to three world wars, God forbid. The first world war, and then the second one, and the third one, God forbid. This is Gog and Magog, the last Gog and Magog. Dear women, so separated to three.
To where?
מצפון, מהחיזבאללה, מלמעלה, מצפון. מצפון תגיע הצרה. מצפון לארץ ישראל הכוונה.
מצפון תפתח הרע בארץ.
כן. And it says... It says that, that Gog ומגוג will come into the land of Israel. ועלית על עמי ישראל כענן לחסות את הארץ באחרית הימים. At the end of days, they will come and they will be like a cloud because there will be so many. It says over there, תהיה ואביאתך אל ארצי למען דעת הגויים אותי בקדשי בך לעיניהם גוג. God says, I will bring you to the land of Israel, and you will be like clouds over the children of Israel. But I will bring you in order that my name will rise in the eyes of the nations, because I am going to kill all of you, God says. And I would like to tell you, it says in Yirmiah, just let me open it, it says in Zechariah,
All
of the nations, Gog and Magog, and all of the nations that are going to come to the land of Israel, to Jerusalem. And it says over there, wait a minute, let me find it first. This is the times. It will start, it says, by the Gera, by the Gaon Mevilna, at the beginning, and the Zohar HaKadosh, it says at the beginning of the next Jewish year, they will come to the land of Israel. Okay, dear women.
Obama's will be elected again next year. And that's what it will be.
Dear women, listen. וזאת תהיה המגפה אשר יגוף השם on chapter 14 in the prophet of Zechariah. It's written, וזאת תהיה המגפה, this will be the plague, אשר יגוף השם, that God is going to do, את כל העמים אשר צבו על ירושלים, that they're going to come on Jerusalem. המק פסעוב הוא עומד על רגליו, God is going to melt them, melt their flesh, and they are standing on the legs. ועיניו תימקנה בחורן, and also their eyes are going to melt in their holes. ולשונו תימק בפיהם, and their tongue is going to melt in their mouth, it says. And it says, והיה ביום ההוא תהיה מהומת השם רבה בהם, which means there will be a lot of noise, and everybody will be, you know, they will be afraid. והחזיקו איש יד רעהו ועלתה ידו על יד רעהו, they will start fighting with each other because of the fear that they're going to have. And it says, וכן תהיה מגפת הסוס, also all the things that they bring, even animals, they will be plagued. והיה כל הנותר מכל הגויים מביאים אל ירושלים, ועלו מדי שנה לשכבות. And then all the ones that will survive from the nations will come to Jerusalem to bow to Hashem. Listen very carefully. And it says also that God is going to be, to show himself on Har HaZetim, on the mountain of Olive in Jerusalem. ועמדו רגליו ביום ההוא על הר הזיתים. It says like his legs, you know, God doesn't have legs, but this is what it's written over here, it's a parable, that his legs will be on the mountain of Olive, אשר על פני ירושלים, מקדם ונתקע הר הזיתים, and the הר הזיתים, the mountain of Olive, will split into two, it will be split into two, מחציו מזרחה, half of it will go east, וימה וגיא גדולה מאוד, and half of it, ומש... חצי הר צפון, and part of it will go north. וחציו נגבה, and part of it will go south. ונסים גיא, זה רעידת אדמה גדולה, זה רעש גדול. It will be a big earthquake. ונסים גיא הרי, כי יגיע גיא הרים אל אצל ונסים, כאשר נסים מפני הרעש, בימי עוזיה מלך יהודה. There was a big earthquake at the time of עוזיה, the king of יהודה, the kingdom of יהודה. God says there will be a big earthquake just like it was then in Jerusalem. and it will be on the mountain of Zaytim, on the mountain of Olive, and the mountain will be split, and then there's going to be a spring of water that will go, water of life that will go through it in the winter and in summer. Slicha? כן, in the winter and in summer. אחר כך יש לו תחיית המתים. In the winter and in the summer. So, dear women, and how many people will be alive? והיה בכל הארץ נאום השם פי שניים בה יקראתו יגבהו. והשלישית יוותר בה. God says, two-thirds of the population of the world will die. Will not be alive. Only one-third will stand. From this one-third going, God is going to cleanse them. So you understand that like 10% of all the population of all over the world will be alive. Okay. And then there will be, she asks me again about Tchiyat HaMetim, that when the dead will become alive. The
33% will stay.
And then from this, God is going to cleanse them. Cleanse this. So at the end, it will be only a small amount. Dear women, listen, she asked me about Tchiyat HaMetim. Tchiyat HaMetim, everybody, everyone is going to become alive. On Tchiyat HaMetim, everybody is going to become alive. All the bad people and the good people. But then it's called the Big Judgment Day. All the bad people will go to their own olam, which means will go to hell, to go to places that they will not come back from there. And only the righteous people will stay alive. So the count will be like a third of the population will stay, because part of it will be also the people that will rise from Tchiyat HaMetim, that will stay alive. You understand? Now tell me, so what is, how can we see that we will also stay alive when Mashiach is here? Dear women, that's exactly what I told you right now. I would like to tell you, you asked me, so I would like to tell you, dear women, that how we can see that we, Bezrat Hashem, will be part of Mashiach's times. We'll have the privilege to be, the merit to be part of it. Only changing our characteristics. Dear women, nothing else. Akol hevel avalim. Everything is nonsense. Not to get angry, not to get hurt. It's very difficult not to answer back, to be polite, to be nice, to remember Hashem, that Hashem looks at us 24 hours, all the time. To remember that we need not to look at you know, the physical world and property and then run after it. Adrabat, tzedakah tatzil mimavet. Dear women, put a lot of money to tzedakah, charity. This is the only thing that will save us. Charity and changing our characteristics, dear women. And wanting Mashiach. The will that Mashiach will be here now, Bezrat Hashem. So all of these things are the things that will help us, Bezrat Hashem, to be part of these times. It's a privilege, it's a merit to be in these times. We are the generation of Mashiach, Baruch Hashem. We are, I cannot believe it, you know, every time I think, maybe Bezrat Hashem, we'll see, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai will see him, Bezrat Hashem. We'll see Rabbi Akiva, we'll see Rabbi Meir Balanes, Rabbi Shalom Shabazi, Bezrat Hashem, that we'll all have the merit to meet them, to see them, Bezrat Hashem. It depends on us, it depends on how we are going to change ourselves. We should remember that everything in this world, like King Solomon said, Hevel Havalim, everything is nonsense. All of the physical things, everything is alive, what we see around us. It's not ours. It's only lended to us in this world. When we give charity, it's charity from Hashem, the money that He gave us, this is His money. He just said, I'm going to give you to keep it while you're here in this world. Let's see what you're going to do with it. So this is what we need. We do not need a mansion. We do not need beautiful cars. We do not need all these privileges, because we do not take everything with us. We don't take anything with us. The only thing we take is our good deeds and our mitzvot, the commandments that we fulfilled. So we need to fulfill the commandments. Dear women, don't be ashamed. Cover your head. Go in a modest way. Don't be afraid of anyone and don't be ashamed. Be beautiful in the eyes of God. It's important, because these are really, we're standing on the end of days. It's true. These are the end of days. So this is the time to repent, to do the tshuva, because when everything starts, when it will start, there will be such a fear in the world. Nobody can do tshuva. Nobody can do it until everything is finished, until all the walls are finished and Mashiach will rule totally have the rule over all of the world, it will take time. It will take like 27 years. So during this time, in order to be part of it, there won't be any time. I'm telling you, there will be such a fear in the world that people will not repent because they will be so afraid. This is the time to do tshuva. This is the time. Dear women, we're going to study Tonot Borat to repent and to change our characteristics, to take this to our heart. Ba'alachta b'drachav, that we should go in Hashem's way. We should not only want to study the Torah, we need to tell Hashem that we want His kingdom in this world. But we need to ask it in mercy. Even though we know it's Beita and it will come, God forbid, with judgment, even though, let's tell Him, please, put also mercy in it. Take all of us, we are the sheep of Hashem. So take us, see to it that we will receive Mashiach with mercy, Bezrat Hashem. I will answer your questions, but first I would like to say that Bezrat Hashem, Shagia Mashiach Tzitim Mimra Benen Amen, Shagia Bevesar Eliyahu Nabi Zechur Atob, Ola Mipa Adara Mechadoro Bidbar Alakha Yachid Berabim Alakha Kerabim. God bless you, dear women.